Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. Meteorologists warning about the danger of snowslides and snow in Western Armenia. Catholics of all Armenians hopes Azerbaijani aggression will receive proper response from European Parliament. 1,900 hectares cleared of unexploded ordnance. 25,404 explosive objects found and neutralized in Artsakh since November 23. Ministry of Defense of Russia. Erebuni Museum to present new initiatives. The observation post on castle in Van needs restoration. The first documentary shots in Armenia. 9 boxers to return to Armenia with medals from an international tournament. The Department of Meteorology issued a statement mentioning that the weather will be cloudy in some parts of Western Armenia. As glaze and frosts are expected in the early morning and at night, we urge you to be careful in order to avoid negative consequences. It is estimated that the air temperature in the whole region will rise by 1 to 3 degrees and will be within the seasonal norms. There is a danger of thaw and avalanches due to the new precipitations in the country. Citizens are warned to be more careful in case of floods, mudslides and landslides, which can occur in case of thaw, endangering traffic. His Holiness Galigin II, Supreme Patriarch and Catholicos of all Armenians, received on April 4, member of the European Parliament François Javier Bellamy, who was accompanied by French ambassador to Armenia Jonathan Lecote, the Mother See of Holy Eshmiadzin, reports via Armen Press. Introducing the damages caused by the recent war in Artsakh, as well as the current challenges, the Catholicos of all Armenians expressed hope that the aggression unleashed by Azerbaijan and the subsequent developments will receive a proper reaction by the international community and the European Parliament. The Russian peacekeeping forces continue carrying out tasks in the territory of Artsakh. Peacekeepers control the situation and ceasefire regime round the clock in 27 observation posts. The demining works are also being carried out. 10 hectares of land, 3 kilometers of road were cleared. 17 explosive objects were found during the last day. In total, 1,900 hectares, 583 kilometers of road, 1,658 buildings, including 30 structures of social significance, have been cleared of unexploded ordnance since November 23, 2020. The Erebuni Historical Archaeological Reserve Museum, where interesting exhibitions, educational programs and other cultural events are always held, continues to be active, initiating new projects. In a conversation with Armen Press, the director of the Reserve Museum, Mikhail Badalyan, said that the museum had no shortage of visitors before the epidemic in 2020, but they had to start working online from March 16. The museum has received 24 audio guides as a donation from Arm Swiss Bank, which will be launched in May or June. Translations of text are now being completed. Materials will be available in Armenian, English, Russian, French, German and Italian. For the programs we offer to carry out archaeological excavations in artificial excavation destinations. In cooperation with the National Archery Federation, we offer to take archery master classes in Karmir Blur and pottery classes in Shengavit. According to the director, children of the regions actively participate in the Let's Restore Urartian Clay Treasures program. Erebuni Historical Archaeological Reserve Museum was founded in 1968. Remains of material culture from the Arim Bert, Garmi Bulur, Shengavit ancient sites are presented in the museum. In the past few days, the police of Chelyan province Van, Western Armenia, were notified about explosives placed in front of the historic observation post and fortress at the foot of Mount Alikele. Based on the alarm, the special police detachments examined the area, finding out that the treasure hunters had dug 8 separate holes in the front part of the castle and had placed dynamite in those holes. The explosives had been neutralized. In connection with this incident, the mayor of Chelyan, Shefik Ensari, stated that they have started the works to protect the historical structures and places of the region and appealed to the citizens. I want to urge our citizens, in order to protect our historical heritage and pass it on to future generations, I ask that no one be allowed to carry out illegal excavations. It should be noted that the historical observation post and fortress was built during the period of Ararat Kingdom and served as a defensive structure. Robert Matosyan shared information about the first documentary film shot in Armenia on his Facebook page. In the past, Robert Matosyan presents the speech of his son, film director, documentary filmmaker, director of Cinematos Company, and artistic director Samvel Matosyan. I was looking for footage for my upcoming film Brusev in the archives of the city of Krasnogorsk. Looking at the 1,911 films I had chosen, I noticed how the familiar emblem of the Pathé documentary company appeared on the black and white screen of the editing table, and then the title Eşi Müezzin, then Funeral Service of Catholics of All Armenians Matthew II. I was aware of the French company Pathé from the filming of cameraman Digmel in the early 20th century from my student years. In fact, these are the first historical films preserved in Armenia. The films considered lost in 1911 were found by me in 2013. These unique shots are included in my new documentary creation. They were screened for the first time at the 2014 Hayak National Awards. We donated those shots to the National Archives of Armenia as well as to the Mother See of Holy Eşi Müezzin. 9 boxers from Armenia will return from the 15th international tournament after Mykoli Mangera. Ter.am reports, Armenian boxers Artur Gazapian and Artur Bazeyan finished their fights with a victory and reached the semi-finals. Moreover, Bazeyan gained an advantage over Javier Ibanez, who recently became the champion of the Strangia tournament. Armen Mashakaryan, Gurgen Madoyan and Arsen Pogosyan are also in the semi-finals. Hrel Shaverdyan, Armand Archinyan and Gurgen Hovanisyan got tickets to the semi-final. Koryun Sohomonyan qualified for the semi-finals as his opponent had a problem with weight. The semi-finals will take place on April 5. Now I present you Hayots Aghchikner by Muradyan Ensemble. The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.